Nothing happened with Lizzie.
It's okay. Doesn't matter.
Yeah, it does. I was drunk. I passed out. I don't even know where I was. Nothing happened with Lizzie. You have to believe me.
It's okay. I do believe you.
Really? Even after what you saw, I know what Lizzie made it look like.
I don't care. Lizzie's sick and pathetic, and she's not going to keep us apart anymore because I'm not letting you go ever again.
I'm ending things with Lizzie for good. I just hope she doesn't fall apart.
You know, I wouldn't worry about that if I were you.
Lizzie's not doing too good.
Lizzie's not sick. She's faking. She has been for a long time. I have proof.
What proof?
A movie that she rented. Some bad TV movie about a woman with postpartum. She lifted lines from it word for word.
No way.
Yeah, she even got teary in the same spots. The girl could win an Emmy.
How'd you figure that out?
I snuck in here. Beth caught me. Actually, we, kind of got into it. Pretty good.
Oh, wow. I would have liked to have seen that one.
Lizzie hasn't changed one bit. She's still a lying, manipulative little witch who will do anything to keep you from leaving her and the baby.
Oh, and I fell for it.
You love your daughter. And Lizzie's act was a good one.
Yeah, it wasn't good enough to fool you.
Well, she had me going for a while, too, but, you know, you are wildly in love with your daughter. It's emotional for you. Lizzie played on that. She used that to her advantage.
Yeah. That's why she made me think that I had...
She pulled out the big guns, all right.
Yeah, so did you. So what made you even look for that? What made you change your mind?
I love you. And we belong together no matter what. Sorry.
Well, I'm through not being with you. I can be a good father to Sarah and not be Lizzie's husband. I mean, probably even make me a better dad. You know, because I'd be happy. It sucks when your parents aren't happy. I know firsthand. Sarah's not going to grow up like that.
Lizzie's not going to give you up so easy.
Well, we'll deal with that when we get to it, but I'm leaving her tonight.
Ready?
I think I should wait and see Lizzie.
You sure about that?
Yeah. I want to do this now.
There's going to be trouble.
After what she pulled, she's the one who's going to have trouble.
Yeah, well, she's still the mother of your baby. What if she tries to keep Sarah from you?
Let her try.
Hey. You need to think out how you're going to do this.
I wish I could just get out of here and go be with you.
Well, we've waited this long. A few more hours won't kill us.
It might kill me. She was desperate. I can do this for you and for Sarah.
I love you.
I love you, too.
Together and save our family. All I need you to do is look extra cute and needy. You're home.
Yeah.
Oh, we missed you.
Hmm. Oh, easy, 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 easy. Okay, come here. Okay, Daddy's got you. Okay.
Thanks. Seeing her makes everything better, right?
Not everything.
What?
I'm leaving.
I brought food.
Did you hear me?
Yes, but it is a filet mignon burger, your favorite, and you don't want it to get cold.
Lizzie, that's not what I meant. I'm not coming back.
I know what you meant. Can you help me get this ready?
I'm not eating. I'm leaving. I only stayed here so that I could tell you in person.
Why bother?
For Sarah, and because I'm not looking to hurt you.
If you love her at all...
You know I do.
Well, she is here. You can't just abandon her.
I'd never abandon her.
No, just me.
Lizzie, it's time. I'm not mad. I don't even care about those things that you did to try and hold on to me.
Whatever Tammy said to you, she's lying.
This is not about her.
Gosh, she just couldn't let you go, could she?
Lizzie.
You are destroying a family.
We were never a family. I tried. I couldn't. I can't. I love Tammy.
Tammy. I am so sick of hearing that name.
Okay.
No, please. Don't
Goodbye,
go. Come
honey.
On.
Goodbye, Sarah. See you soon.
No, Jonathan, I can't. I can't live without you, okay? I can't. I can't do this alone.
Well, I will be here to help you with her, but we can't do this anymore.
And by this, do you mean parenting and taking care of each other?
Stop.
No, please.
Stop.
I don't understand. I don't understand how you could be this cruel.
Stop.
I am sick.
You're not sick.
Did Tammy tell you that? Because how on earth would she know? Did she have a baby?
All right, fine. You sick?
Yes.
You sick?
Yes.
We're going to take you to the hospital.
No.
Yes, we are. We're going to take you to the hospital. You're going to stay there until you feel better. In the meantime, Sarah's going to live with me and Tammy at the Beacon.
No. I am her mother and you are her father and she belongs with us. I don't want Tammy anywhere near her.
Well, you can't have it both ways, Lizzie.
Come on. Let's just stay. It's not too late. All I need is you. I just need you.
I will call you tomorrow about Sarah. Where we go from here.
Don't, please don't go.
Stop.
Don't. Please. If you walk out that door, anything could happen to me and Sarah. Anything. So much for no more lies.
Stand up. Stand up. What did that mean just now? That you're going to hurt yourself or hurt Sarah?
No.
Lizzie, you just said if I leave, anything could happen to you or the baby. What did that mean?
I just meant that we need you here with us.
Good. Because I'm a hell of a lot better at playing psycho than you are. If you ever think about hurting that kid.
Jonathan, I would never hurt Sarah. I can't even believe that would come out of your mouth.
After all the stunts, I wouldn't put anything past you.
All of that stuff that I did because I was fighting for us. Because I was fighting for that beautiful little girl.
Okay, well, we've made mistakes. We don't have to make them anymore.
Oh, this is so easy for you,
it's
isn't it?
It's not easy.
Oh, we should have stayed away from Springfield when we had the chance. If we did, if we had, this wouldn't be happening. None of this would be happening. We would be together. We'd be happy.
We never would have lasted.
Yes, we would have. If Tammy wasn't in your face every single day, we would have worked out. You could love me.
It'll always be Tammy.
Yeah, yeah. The one who stalked you for several months after you told her that it was over. The one that followed us to our honeymoon.
You knew. You knew she was there. That's when you started trashing the place.
You left me no other choice.
I'm out of here.
No. No. Jonathan, you promised that you would take care of us. You promised that you would take care of her. Please don't go.
Tammy. Oh, not again. I took you down last time. I'll do it again.
I didn't come here to fight with you. I came here to warn you.
Well, I don't want to hear it.
You're making a big mistake, Tammy. I have a very bad feeling.
You want to know what you can do with your really bad feelings?
Listen to me. You're in trouble.
Good night, Beth. Oh, and by the way, Jonathan and Lizzie are over. Nothing you do can keep them together.
He's leaving her?
As we speak.
Oh, Lizzie.
She'll recover. And probably move on to someone else's boyfriend. Hey, there's your cause. Why don't you help Lizzie find someone who's actually available? Save her a lot of heartache.
This isn't over.
Oh, it's over.
Tammy, I have a bad feeling.
You don't scare me, Beth, so you might as well not bother trying.
I've had this feeling before. The dread, the uneasiness. The last time I felt this way was just before Philip took the kids.
Oh, Beth, come on, give me a little bit of credit.
Sound crazy?
As your daughter.
I'm serious. Something is building. It's growing. And if it gets too big, nobody will be able to stop it.
It's okay, baby. I would never desert you.
Does that mean that you're staying?
Lizzie, we made Sarah together. Take care of her together.
Oh, thank God. Mom, what are you doing here?
I called her.
Why?
Because I didn't want you to be alone.
But I thought that you were...
I'll call you.
No, no, wait, no, don't go.
Thank you.
I'm doing this for my daughter.
No, don't go,
Lizzie,
Jonathan.
Lizzie,
no,
let him, just let him go.
Come on, no.
Let him go. Let him go, honey.
Please, Jonathan, don't
Lizzie,
go.
Lizzie, we could never be together. I would not be a good husband to you, okay? Kiss Sarah goodnight for me.
No.
Beth, please take care of her.
I can't do this without you. No. Everything.
It is done. You're stuck with me.
Welcome home.
Never have to be a part of her again.
Mommy is going to tell a little story today, too. There once was a girl named Goldilocks, and she finally got what was coming to her.
Everything feels right now.
I should have left Lizzie a long time ago.
I don't even care about any of that anymore.
I know, but we wasted so much time.
But you're home now.
Almost. First things first. Yeah. Voila.
You miss Sarah.
Yeah. That's just weird knowing that tomorrow I'm going to wake up in a different place than she is.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm where I want to be. I just wish she could be here, too.
That little girl is so lucky to have you for a daddy.
And she's going to know you now, too. She's going to grow up with real love.
Yeah. The happily ever after kind.
At the table in the kitchen, there were three bowls of porridge.
Time for grown-up stuff, sir.
She was hungry. She tasted the porridge from the first bowl. This porridge is too hot, she exclaimed. So she tasted the porridge from the second bowl. This porridge is too cold, she said. So she tasted the last bowl of porridge. Ah, this porridge is just right,
Sarah,
she said happily. And she ate it all
up. You know that Mommy would never leave you in here by yourself if it wasn't really important. And it is. Yeah, it's everything.
So just, hang in there, okay? I promise it'll be worth it. Mommy will be right back. Daddy will be with her.
I am now officially a loser.
Excuse me?
Oh, I used to make fun of people who talk about their family stuff and kids' cribs.
And now all cool kids like you used to be can make fun of you.
Great.
I don't really think you've changed that much. I always knew you were mushy.
Mushy?
Mushy. You were just afraid.
Me? No.
Yes, you were afraid to be happy.
Happy? I didn't even know what that was. I thought it was people walking around smiling, laughing all day. I just thought they were on a lot of drugs.
Well, I love your smile. I love the way you smile at Sarah.
Oh, I can't not smile at her. Oh, Sarah. I want her to, you know, expect that. I want her to totally take me for granted.
She won't take you for granted.
Well, she should. Every kid should be able to count on their dad.
You couldn't. Neither could I when I was little.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I want Sarah to expect, you know, birthday presents, Christmas presents, and they're gonna be there year after year, you know. I remember when I was a kid, my dad, reeling me in. He'd be like, "Don't worry, Johnny. He's like, this year, we'll have it, do it up big, we'll have a real Christmas." You know, or birthday or whatever. And I'd, you know, buy into it because I was a kid, I'd get excited and then come home and he's face down drunk on the couch and mom's crying in the other room and, you know, eventually you just give up hope and ultimately, you know, I stop going home. But not that for Sarah.
You are never gonna let that happen to her. She's only gonna get good things, I promise.
You're the best gift I could ever give her.
Not better than a pink tricycle with streamers, though.
Better than a pink tricycle with streamers.
Wow!
Oh, I love you. I just wish I knew back then everything was gonna turn out like this. I don't have to do that now.
Oh, no. This does not even feel real yet. I need you unpacked. I need your toothbrush in the bathroom. I need your ratty t-shirts and your holy underwear in my dresser right now, okay?
Hey!
What? These are beat. But whatever.
Our dresser?
Oh. Our dresser, sorry. Almost forgot.
Don't get too used to this place, though.
What do you mean?
I mean, we gotta get a place of our own.
Another one?
Not a place like that. I could have Sarah hanging out in a bar or a barn or a fishing shack. I want to get a place that's good enough for you guys.
Well, any place where you are is good enough for me. Although I can't speak for Sarah.
Okay. No, I was thinking we could get, one of those places with the roof and the, obviously, and rooms and get a yard.
Do you mean a house?
Yes, a house! This, you know, Sarah will grow up with us and good environment and people who really love her and...
Oh, that's not a house. That's a home. It's like, 1 minute,
you know where your life is going, and then the next, you're making this huge, lifelong commitment to another person.
Your child.
Which is wonderful, because marriage is like this beautiful, sacred thing that's supposed to last forever. Isn't that what God says?
Well, the vows aren't exactly...
Right when you and your husband, you're finally getting used to the married life, and bam! There's like this baby that you're suddenly supposed to get ready for.
About your babe.
I don't want to be thinking bad things about my baby. Maybe I should be thinking about something else. Saving my marriage. It all goes together, right?
Well, yes, but let's get back to Sarah, about your depression.
You mean how it's wrecking my family? Because I don't think that Jonathan understands postpartum depression. Can you make him see how much Sarah and I need him?
Father Ray!
Not now, Mickey. I'm with someone.
The lady's car. Someone stole it. They broke in and drove off.
Oh, my God! Sarah is in there!
See, it's okay. Sarah is fine. You left her with the sitter.
No, I lied! We have to call the cops. Somebody stole my baby!
I was thinking about something like that.
It's okay.
What's wrong with it? It's got three bedrooms, got a garage, got a pool.
We'd have to rob a bank. Check this one out.
It's falling apart.
No, it's a fixer-upper.
It's a wreck. What do you even like about that?
Hey, it has one of these old wraparound porches.
Yeah, but we're not gonna live on the porch.
Yeah, but I could plant flower boxes and put out rocking chairs or a porch swing. A porch swing.
Tammy Winslow, you are a cheesy cornball.
You love me. Be about Sarah.
What, Lizzie?
Jonathan, they took the car. It was only for a minute. I thought that she would be okay.
What? Slow down.
Sarah was inside. Somebody stole her.
Someone stole Sarah. Lizzie, you're messing with me.
No, I am for real. I am at church. The car was parked right outside. Who steals a car from a church?
Lizzie, what did you do?
No, this wasn't my fault. Father Ray is right here. He can explain it to you. He doesn't believe me. Help me.
Lizzie!
What? What is it?
I'm not sure, but it has something to do with Sarah. Come on.
The police are on the way.
Oh, thank God.
Okay, now tell me again what happened, calmly. You forgot your baby in the car.
I didn't. It was only supposed to be for a minute.
Lizzie, you left your daughter in the car? Why?
So that I wouldn't lose my husband. Where is he? What's taking so long? We have to find my
baby.
Lizzie,
we're doing everything we can. You have to calm down, please.
Oh, my God, Jonathan, thank God.
What the hell did you do with my kid? What did you do with Sarah?
You're hurting me.
Stop.
Oh, God, she's my kid, too.
You wouldn't leave your dog in a car.
You left
what kind
me
of person?
Alone.
Your mother was with you.
No, but you left me, and we needed you. You think I wanted Sarah to see me like this, bawling my eyes out in church?
You selfish! It is the middle of winter, Lizzie. Damn it! What is she giving you? This fake postpartum act?
It's real, Tammy.
Yours is
it's
fake.
Real.
This isn't helping.
She did make
it. Oh, you shut up, Tammy.
Do not talk to her like that,
please. You're so worried about her. My God, you make it sound like I would do this on purpose.
You would sell her online if it got you what you wanted.
Lizzie?
Oh, my God, Mom. They think that this is all my fault.
Well, it is your fault.
I didn't abandon my family.
You left an infant in a car.
Okay, this is not the time. What do we know so far?
The police have issued an Amber Alert and put out an APB on the car.
Well, they're taking too long. I'm leaving.
I just got a call. They found the car. Was my kid inside?
You stay put right here.
That's him?
All right, that's him.
All right, back.
Where is she? She's in the car. She's in the car.
Get out of my way.
She's safe. We're waiting on a doctor.
She's hurt?
No, she's fine, okay? We just want to make sure. Jonathan!
Hey. Hey, baby girl. Daddy's here.
Sarah, oh my goodness, thank God.
It's okay, she's fine. She's getting away
from her. Sarah, wait, I just want to see her. Is she okay? I swear I never meant for any of this to happen.
I will never let you hurt her again.
I want to hold my daughter.
Let's find somewhere private. Come on.
Sarah is not going anywhere with her. Excuse me. Frank, you can let him go. I don't care. She did this.
No! No, he's the one that stole my car. He's the one that stole our daughter. Please tell him. I didn't mean for it to happen like this. Tell them, please.
I didn't mean it either, Father.
Father, you know who this is?
He was one of our altar boys. Frank, he's not a bad kid.
Oh, well, what about me? I'm not bad either. Mom, you know that I love Sarah. I would never try to hurt her. Mom! This wasn't my fault!
Honey, I know that you're hurting. But what you did, leaving Sarah like that, leaving her anywhere, I'm thinking of Sarah.
So am I! God, none of this would be happening if he hadn't stolen my car. And I wouldn't have even gone for help if he hadn't walked out on... He wanted us. Oh, God, you're so jealous. You turned everyone against me.
No, you did that to yourself, Lizzie.
It's my baby, Tammy, and I don't want you anywhere near her. Keep her away from our baby.
I want custody.
No.
Yeah. I'm filing for tomorrow.
You can't do that. You can't do that.
I have more than enough against you.
Oh, why? You keep hurting me.
Would you get it together? Because you are hurting Sarah, and she cannot protect herself, so I will.
No, I can protect her. I can.
No, she's going to stay with me until we get this figured out.
No, Jonathan, you can't take her.
On Guiding Light.
Did you ever think you'd see this? The three of us? It's nice when dreams come true, huh?
I'm gonna be with Tammy either way. So either we get this done, Lizzie, or we can do it the hard way. They're gonna come after us.
The Spaldings?
No, I'm not doing that.
Oh, come on, let's just get the tickets, get on the plane, and go.
Hey, how long have you been doing that? Do you ever think you'd see this? The three of us? It's nice when dreams come true, huh?
Finally.
Yeah, finally. And forever.
Yes, and then we're gonna get your little piggies. Little piggy, little piggy. Little piggy, little piggy, little piggy. It's gonna be until she can use that toilet bowl.
You're kidding, right?
A man can dream, can he? Yes, he can, little Sarah. Yes, he can. Yes, he can.
We have this one, and this one, and that one.
Middle one.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, Reva gave her that one.
Yeah, you can totally tell.
Look at that. What do you think, babe? What do you think with your little hat?
She likes it. So what do you
want to
do today?
I don't know. It's a nice day out. We'll go outside for a walk.
I wasn't asking you.
Oh.
Okay. Okay.
I did not get her this.
I came!
Spoil you, little girl.
What was I supposed to do? She was pointing at it.
She's pointing. Really?
Look like it. Look like it.
It's impressive.
Oh, she's so beautiful. What's her name?
Sarah.
How old?
She's almost, what, 2 months?
Yeah, she was born on Thanksgiving, so.
Well, you look fantastic. Congratulations on the new addition. You make a lovely family.
Thank you. Do you see, little one? Daddy's not the only one who thinks you're perfect. What?
You don't know?
That lady?
I am not the one who gave birth 2 months ago.
Really? Maybe she just liked your coat.
I'm the new addition here.
What are you talking about?
She called us a family, Jonathan, but we're not.
What? You mean like a normal family? Name one family in this town that's remotely normal. See, there you go.
But we've been pretending to be that kind of family since we woke up this morning.
Mm-hmm. I don't pretend.
You did with Lizzie.
Not with you. Never with you. Today you and me are being together.
Mm-hmm. Except that, we're not together.
Forgot to take it off.
Yeah. You forgot. You're used to wearing it. It's okay.
Here, take it. Toss it. Burn it. Melt it. I don't care.
No, it's not just about the ring, Jonathan. Sarah's not mine. And technically, neither are you.
We'll change it.
What are we doing?
You know.
No, I'm not doing that.
Oh, come on, let's just get the tickets, get on the plane, and go.
But Lizzie
doesn't even want to be your mom. She stayed pregnant so she could get with Coop, and it was too late.
Yeah, so she got you.
No, you have me. Lizzie left Sarah in a car.
Okay, so what? So what? We get on a plane, and then what?
We figure it out when we get there.
Jonathan.
You want to be together? Me, you, and Sarah?
Yes.
Well, then we got to make that happen. No one's going to give it to us, okay? We stay here, we got to deal with Alan and Lizzie. We get on a plane, we never have to look back again. I was about to buy the tickets, but where do you want to go?
Please, no.
Tammy. This could be like San Francisco. You remember that? We were all set to pack up and go?
Yeah, before you had Sarah. You can't just get on a motorcycle and disappear across the country or hop on a plane to who knows where. Those days are kind of over now.
It's different.
You can't just take a baby away from its mother. You know that. Not like this.
Mother left baby in the car.
Okay, Lizzie screwed up. But she didn't walk out on Sarah for good. Look, even if Sarah wasn't a part of this, I couldn't do it. We would just be running from one hiding spot to another. I thought you wanted to be done with all of that.
I do.
Then we can't run at the first sign of trouble.
All we ever have is trouble.
We're here. We're still together. After everything we've been through, we shouldn't have to run. Whatever we come up against, we can handle it. Jonathan, tell me we can do that.
We should have got on that plane, Tammy.
We did the right thing.
Sometimes doing the right thing is doing the wrong thing, you know? How long is it going to take us to figure that out? You saw Lizzie when I told her I wanted custody. She freaked out. They're going to come after us.
The Spauldings? They should be afraid that we're going to come after them. Really, what do they have that we don't? Okay, fine. But, you know, we have a lot, too.
A lot, too?
I'm trying.
I don't know.
No more sneaking around or looking over our shoulders or running away, okay? No one can break this up now. I'm with you and Sarah. What?
That's the judge from the case with Alan over custody. I know, I didn't think of this sooner.
You want what?
An annulment. It's not just for me. It's for you, too. You need to get over it.
Over what? Our marriage?
Well, we never slept together.
We did do sleep together. How do you think we got Sarah?
Not since we were married.
It's not for lack of trying on my part.
I talked to a judge. The one from Alan's custody hearing.
What?
He said that we don't have to go through the court system and worry about lawyers and stuff like that, that we can just sit down with him and talk it out, tell him what happened.
I won't do that.
All right, I'm going to be with Tammy either way. So either we get this done, Lizzie, or we can do it the hard way. Either way, it's going to happen. I set up a meeting for 11 o'clock.
Today?
Today, Cross Creek. Can you be there?
I still live there. What about Sarah?
What about Sarah? We could have lost her yesterday.
I thought she would be safe in the car. It was an accident.
Accident? You chose to leave her in the car.
I didn't choose to have my car stolen.
You're so worried about being a good mom. If you were putting Sarah first, would your little accident have happened? 11 o'clock today, Cross Creek. Be there.
Can I bring you another cup of tea?
No, thank you. Your wife said she would be here.
Yeah, but she's always late. It's fine.
We could call her again.
Maybe you should just file a formal petition.
Well, why don't we just give her a few more minutes?
I'm sorry.
Oh, come on. Look, just... She's gonna be here. She knows that she has to...
But in order to grant you an annulment, I must declare your marriage invalid.
How does that work?
The state has several reasons that are grounds for an annulment. You must prove that those reasons existed at the time of your marriage. Questions? Mrs. Randall. When you're asking for this annulment is Mr. Randall's refusal to consummate the marriage?
Well, correct? The marriage wasn't even real in the first place. I mean, we were threatened by her grandfather. Is he?
Look, if there's something that you don't understand, some
no,
questions...
No, I understand. Can I say something?
Of course.
When I first got pregnant, everything was so confusing. One minute, I knew exactly what I wanted, and the next, it changed, and I wanted something else.
That's understandable.
But he always wanted her. That's why he wouldn't sleep with me. He said his vows to me, but he meant them for her, his own cousin. Aren't there some rules against that?
Lizzie, stop.
The first time they did it, he didn't even tell her that he was her cousin. How sick is that? How messed up is that? Everyone to think that it's okay that they're together, but it's not. It is sick. Sick. In some states, illegal. And now, they want to rip my baby from my arms. And just make this whole marriage just make me disappear. And then you put your big fat stamp of approval on it. You can't let them do this. It is wrong. Everything about it is wrong.
I thought you both agreed to this annulment.
I think she wants you to think that I'm a bad person. She's right, kind of. I was. When I first got here, I was selling drugs. You can ask her if she was the one buying them. The main reason I came to this town in the first place was to get back at my mom for the crappy life I had because she gave me her adoption. Tammy was the part of the family, and I thought we'd try to get back at mom than to ruin the best one in the worst way. Everyone hated me. For that, not just my family, but my mom. only reason I did the whole thing was to hurt her, and she was the one who wanted to give me a second chance. It was the last person I expected to... But, well, you know, next to last. Tammy saw something in me she thought was worth saving, and I just wanted her to go that way. And then there was the fire.
The first fire?
Yeah, there was a few fires. I'm not saying that it changed me, but there was something in me that wanted to save her. And I thought maybe whatever it was what she was looking for in me.
Fading the violence.
Let him speak.
You like what happened next? Town. He moved here. He's adopted dad. He's a jerk. Mean guy. And he just accepted he didn't want to be like him, you know, some deadbeat's his wife.
And his son?
You could find all this in the police reports. He died in a boating accident. He deserved to. He went for her, for him.
Take my hand, come on. Take my hand and this is over. You're free. Leave him. Come with me.
And Tammy was gonna marry a guy who was almost as bad as my dad.
Then fate threw them together. Spare me.
I can't promise you much of anything except this. You will be the most important person in the world to me. The one. The only one.
Who are we here for? You and her or you and me?
Lizzie, there is no you and me. We decided it was just long before you were involved. It's not a big secret.
What's right? The answer is nobody knows. How long do we hide the secret dying to be told? I'm not afraid of what anybody has to say. You say it's our time. Can you love me? Will you love me? With the lights on, yeah, when the lights are on, let the world see, hey, let our love be strong. And if everyone is watching us, let them watch, let them talk, just believe what we need is what.
Watch, it's only like 2 minutes later.
Maybe it'll help just to not think about it. Well, why don't we go get some air until he gets here? Hey!
Hey, you see him?
Hello. Hello. Is this new?
Yeah.
It's pretty. Yeah, that's right, my sunshine girl. Sleepy, huh?
Hello again.
Hi.
Hi. Hello, Your Honor.
Do you want to get a table?
No, I have just been informed about the incident yesterday with the baby.
My car was stolen.
With the baby inside.
We were in front of a church.
I think it's significant that you didn't mention it earlier.
I'm sorry.
No. I'm impressed that you didn't use it, particularly in light of what your wife said.
We both said things.
He spoke about himself and was honest about his shortcomings. You only spoke about him.
Because I have less shortcomings.
Maybe your influence on Mr. Randall has done him some good.
He is good.
I am prepared to sign the annulment order.
Well, what about Sarah?
Well, Sarah's custody is a little more complicated. I suggest that you all retain counsel until I have time to review the facts of this case. But in light of yesterday's incident, Mr. Randall will retain custody until this all gets sorted out. Mrs. Ramp, excuse me. Miss Spaulding.
Seen the beginning of this one which was before.
We'll just have to get you a new one, won't we, sweetie?
Yeah, look who's spoiling her now.
Yeah, well, I feel like I can now. You know, yesterday we didn't know. Guess we still don't know.
Yeah, but I get it. You know, we're getting closer.
Yeah, and we've got a little routine going now.
Yeah, we got 2 days of a routine.
You know, I could spend every day like this with you and Sarah.
We will.
Even more beautiful than yesterday.
Thank you.
The scary lady's gone, Tammy. Are you worried she's gonna say we look like a normal family?
Shut up.
Whoa.
Nothing.
Jonathan Randall?
Oh, crap. No one ever tracks me down to give me good news.
Sorry.
Okay, maybe it's nothing, right?
It's something. I'm not married anymore.
That fast?
Look.
Oh, my God. Oh. Oh, when Lizzie started saying all that stuff to the judge yesterday.
Yeah, but, I mean, he said that he was going to give us the annulment.
I know, but I didn't want to believe it until it was real. Lizzie was so bitter.
Well, what she said doesn't matter anymore.
No, but what you said does. You just told the judge the truth.
The truth. The truth was not all good.
Yeah, but you stuck with it instead of playing dirty like Lizzie.
I guess it could have ended bad for us.
We got a new beginning.
Another one?
Hey, the last one that we are ever going to need.
She's sleeping?
Yeah.
One down, one to go.
Sydney's already asleep. Do you think they'll be best friends when they grow up?
No. What?
They're still in diapers. How should I know?
I just think it'd be cool to have a best friend since birth.
Well, you already have one.
Not including mothers. Besides, we've had our issues.
Me.
She loves you now.
Go on.
Okay, she likes you.
Well, it's because you domesticated me.
What are Zach and Jude up to?
Video games. Boys needed to refuel. Uh-oh.
You really think I domesticated you? What does that even mean?
Places like this have been my worst nightmare. We're babysitting. Somebody asked me to babysit.
They asked me to babysit, and only because Ashley was working.
Whatever, I'm saying. I don't know, a place like this now with all the kids stuff going on, I really like it. I really want to have it, you know? You and Sarah made me want that.
You mean like one day a switch inside you just kind of flipped?
Mm-hmm. How'd you know?
Because same thing kind of happened to me with you.
Mm.
You know, I hated you. Hated you. I hated you.
Okay.
But then, you know, one day I started seeing things that made me believe maybe. I woke up one day and I couldn't do anything but love you. Just like that.
I bet you never thought you'd be raising a kid with me.
Didn't think it'd be Lizzie's kid. Jonathan, I have never been able to predict anything with us. But the big picture just keeps getting better and better, so let's just go with it.
Hmm? Let's go with it.
Yeah, what?
This. I'm not married anymore.
Yeah, I know.
So let's get married. Let's do it now.
We're babysitting right now?
Well, not now. Today now, later now.
Are you? You're proposing right now. You are really proposing to me.
Yeah. What? What am I? Wait, like this? You?
No. Okay, that's not you. No.
You want it like this?
Oh, oh.
Come on, let's get married. You know it's what we want. It's what we've been waiting for, right? Oh. Tammy, say something.
I say yes. Yes, let's get married.